Well, we continue our conversation about Israel by looking at the film that's just been released, titled Junction 48. The film centers on Karim, an aspiring Palestinian rap artist who lives in an impoverished, mixed Palestinian-Jewish city near Tel Aviv called Lid. Junction 48 shows how Karim and his Palestinian girlfriend Manar and their friends use hip-hop to fight back against Israel's policies. The role of Karim is played by Tamer Nafar, a rap artist with the Palestinian hip-hop group Dam. This is the film's trailer.
I understand that the fridge was new. That is why it was repossessed.
Wow, that's really cool.
Honest.
Incredible.
You're an Arabic Israeli rapper?
I'd say so.
We welcome Karim Awad. Shut up, he's a real star.
My songs are not political. I just describe the place I live.
They're tearing down Talal's house.
We have the right to demonstrate.
Let's make music.
We are a traditional family. Manar's performance will bring us shame. And if that happens, we'll be forced to use other means with her.
We have 500,000 downloads and haven't even started. Can you imagine how this might end?
Israelis, cousins, families, enemies everywhere.
That's not funny.
Shut up.
Don't make us angry.
We have to stick together.
There is always this thing pulling me down.
That's the trailer for Junction 48. To talk more about the film, we are joined by the film's director, Udi Aloni, Israeli-American film director, and the lead actor and musical director, Tamer Nafar. Udi is an award-winning filmmaker. The director and producer of Junction 48, his previous films include Local Angel, Forgiveness, and Art Violence, the author of What Does a Jew Want? On Binationalism and Other Specters. Tamer Nafar is the lead actor in Junction 48, the music director of the film, also co-authored the screenplay. He is a rap artist with the Palestinian hip-hop group Dam. Tamer is a Palestinian citizen of Israel who lives in Lid, as Israelis call it, Lod, this community that the film is based in, just near Tel Aviv airport. Udi, talk about this film. You haven't gotten enormously positive reviews from the New York Times in the past. They've now written five pieces since this won, what, the Audience Award here at Tribeca Film Festival.
The first award.
The first award.
The Audience Award was in Berlin.
Oh,
we're
the
doing
Audience
well.
Award. And you just got the New York Times did it as a critic's pick. But this is a fascinating film that also, I think, for the first time in a feature film, includes a housing demolition.
We were very—Tamer and me are very close friends for 15 years. We are doing a lot of stuff together. And I think, really, we're following Edward Said's call to create a binational language. And not only we create art together, we're standing on many house demolition against the bulldozers together. And we all the time try to work between art, theory, and action. We always with our body in the place. But the movie really has to be that. For me, when I think about house demolition, the quality has to be perfect, because we are not only demolish house of Palestinian, it's a culture demolition. Israel put so much energy to destroy the Palestinian as a culture that the minute Tamer referred to himself as Palestinian, not as an Israeli Arab, the Minister of Culture tried to destroy every show of Tamer around the country. And she stepped out when he performed in our Oscar winning. So the house demolition for us has to be also the relation of from 48. It's an ongoing demolition. It's an ongoing Nakba. It's an ongoing disaster from the Palestinians. And shooting it was, for me, very important, the details, the way I experience it. And Tamer and me work really, like, even the way the people speak, the way they react, the way that the day after, they can go all on the demolition and do a song, a protest song. people here in America don't destroy how they can sing after the house was demolished, how they can smile. But it's an ongoing fight. You cannot, like, let the Israeli destroy their spirit. So the house demolition, it's also the performance after of Tamer on it, in front of audience, said, we will rebuild this house again. In the Negev, there is a village that the Bedouin Palestinian built already, I think, 70 times. Again and again, after Israel demolished their house. Just for you to know, in Israel, they demolish a Bedouin village now, Hiran, just in order to bring Jews' village on it. Not for any other reason. They really replace Jews with Arabs on a place that Arabs live for 50 years already.
So, well, let's go to a clip from the film Junction 48. In this scene, Karim is being interviewed on an Israeli news program.
And now we have Karim Avid.
Awad.
Sorry, it's Awad.
Awad.
The first Israeli Arab rapper.
What a celebrity.
My songs are not political. They just describe the place I come from.
Looks like he's been doing this all his life.
You come from Lod, which ironically is a city most Israelis don't know. Why do you think that is?
Lod is a tough place, especially on our side. I'm talking about poverty, neglected schools. I'm talking about settlers, police brutality towards us, police corruption. We live 15 kilometers from... Sorry, I can say... Right?
Funny guy.
I'm not trying to be funny. I'm trying to explain that you don't know we exist.
You said you're not political.
I'm not political, but does it make sense to you that to build a museum of coexistence, they have to demolish my friend's home?
I swear, he's the man.
He shouldn't have mentioned the house. It will open the door for evil.
Well, let's go to another clip from the film Junction 48.
And they want me to get married. That way, I'll be someone else's responsibility, not theirs. What do you think?
Sorry, eh? Honestly?
I'm being serious now.
I'm glad I don't have a sister.
You don't want a problem like me?
Manar, we talked about this. I have no income, no job, nothing. If I make it big, we can live off the music. Okay? Do you want to come and sing with us tonight at the Marley?
In Hebrew?
In Hebrew, yes.
Go perform for the Jews by yourself.
My love, I didn't mean it. I was just kidding. Come back.
Karim, my cousins are here.
What are you talking about? So, Jews, cousins, family, same.
Not funny. Huh? Now, for real, Karim, I can't have my cousins following me around.
So those are clips from the film Junction 48. So, Udi Aloni, you directed this film. Can you talk about what the character Karim says in the first clip about his songs, responding to a question about whether his work is political? And then this last scene between Karim and his girlfriend, Nafar.
Yeah, I really want to tell you, it's good that you
put... Manar. Manar is the name of his girlfriend.
It's very important. The film is fun. We want to be all to create high art. And this is when Tamer said, I'm not political. It's kind of the wish of the oppressed to be non-political. But really, the only person who can be non-political is only the privileged. Only the privileged can say, I'm doing pure art. So when Tamer said, I'm not political, and we have a great song, Anamish Politi, that it's really mean, even if I come with a bag on a bus, I become a political entity because everyone looked at me. And...
I wanted to ask Tamer to also respond to this. Tamer Nafar, who is with us from afar, who is with us, it seems, much farther than he is because of this long delay when we ask him a question. But he's in the studios of WILL in Champaign-Urbana. When that question was put to you, you're playing Kareem, but it's semi-autobiographical. You co-wrote the screenplay. And you said, my songs are not political. They just describe the place I come from. Can you talk about what that means to you, Tamer?
First off, the screenplay was a cooperation with me and Ori Moverman, the amazing Ori Moverman. And this specific interview in the movie, when he says, I'm not political, it becomes a song, like Udi said, Anamish Politi, which you can get it now from iTunes, from the soundtrack of Junction 48. The whole music was by me and by Itamar Ziegler. And when he say, I'm not political, I think he really means it, that he's not political. They are demolishing his friend's house, and he's going to stand up for his friend. For him, it's not political. But the reasons for demolishing the house are political. But for him, it's not political. Or maybe that's the turn-up point where he needs to understand, where he starts to understand that he has some responsibility because the place he's living in. And you cannot not be political, because it's not a privileged thing, that, like Udi said. So being a Palestinian living inside of Israel, I cannot see you not being political. To tell somebody not to be political, that's like tell women not to be feminist after the awful quotations that Trump said. So
I also wanted to ask you. I wanted to ask you, Tamer, about the house that you all built for the film that you would then demolish, and the coincidence of once you built it, you got a message from Tel Aviv, from the Israeli government, that this house would have to be demolished. Is that right? And what was that like in your community of Lid, what it meant to demolish this house?
Udi decided to build the whole house with the furniture in it, just so you can feel it, just so you can feel the cinema of it, just so you can even feel the dust in your eyes when the house is demolished, just so you can feel what these people, what we go through. I mean, I live in Lid. Lid is an Israeli city according to the officiality of the city itself, and it's and it has more than around 30,000 Palestinians, Arab, who pay taxes, who vote, like this whole democracy thing. And we still get our house demolished. And we're talking about more than 300 houses being demolished. And while we talk now, we have almost 5,000-6,000 houses with warrants demolitions that can happen in every minute when the Israeli government decides. So for my people in Lid to watch this house demolition, that was very tearful, and that was very hard to see it coming. To see it finally getting documented, because normally in Israeli movies about Palestinians, they don't show you the physical occupation. They don't show you the house demolition. You normally, if you want to see something bad, it's always the Arabic who's bad, who's extremely explosion, who's extreme. You can show the physical of it, but if they want to be like liberal, they will talk about the occupation, but they will not show how ugly it is. And I'm very proud that we did that. I'm very proud that Udi directed it in this way, and actually you can see, and I remember that was one of the hardest scenes for us on the set. Even the Jews on the set, who are not politically 100% with me or Udi, it was hard for them to see that, and it was good for me, satisfying for me to look and to show this is what is happening every day. So that's one of the most scenes that really influences me in the movie.
We just have 30 seconds, Udi, but this film is not only opening in New York. I mean, you're going to be flying to join Tamer in Chicago tonight. It's opening on the West Coast as well.
And there is a way that, called TAG, people can really order screening all over the country. So it's if you go to Junction 48.film, you can see the whole system, how it works. I just want to say on the second part, this film really fight for women's rights, not very strong inside the community. And that's why it was so beautiful to hear Linda Sarsour saying, feminism who doesn't accept me with the hijab is not feminism, because the fight of Tamer and me, except of do great art, is to understand that fighting for women's rights and fighting against Israeli oppression, it's the same fight.
We want to thank you both for being with us. Udi Aloni, Israeli-American director of Junction 48, Tamer Nafar, the film's lead actor and musical director, rap artist with the Palestinian hip-hop group Dom. When we come back, thousands of leaked documents published by WikiLeaks describe CIA programs to hack into both Apple and Android cell phones, smart TVs, even cars. We'll speak with the head of Electronic Frontier Foundation. Stay with us.